You've done it. You've worked hard all your life. You've put in your time, and now it is finally time to reap the rewards. You're retiring. Congratulations. The only question now is, what do you do with all of your newfound free time? How do you spend it? Where do you spend it? And with so many amazing places to visit or live in the world, how do you narrow them all down to just one? Well, you could spend the next 40 years Googling it, or you can just watch this video. Settle in, my friend, because we are about to go on a journey of the best places to retire in the world. But this is not your ordinary top 10 list. Oh no, I have scoured the internet for the best of the best of the best, the number one places to retire on all of the top lists. We've got the best place for quality of life, the best place for cost of living, for zero taxes, and the best place to retire from the retirement gurus themselves, international living. My role here is to be your guide. I'm going to take you through each place, give you my reaction and opinion to each one, and let you know the pros and cons and if I agree with their number one choices. And at the end of the video, we're gonna save the best for last, of course, and I'm going to tell you my recommendation for where you should retire. But first, what makes a place a good place to retire? Well, I went over to ask the 5,000 people in my Facebook group what they thought, and they overwhelmingly told me that a high quality of life with a low cost of living are the two main things that they're looking for. So that's what we're gonna look for on this list. Let's get started. Kicking things off in 10th place, we have the best place to retire early and cheap. This is a top 15 list by a gentleman named Vagabond Awake. You may have seen some of his videos before on YouTube. Let's see what he has to say. Okay, so he's going with Bali. That is a pretty interesting choice out of everywhere in the world, but I like it. I don't hate it. Bali is a great place to live. It's a very tropical and beautiful. It's very affordable, and there are a lot of foreigners living there for that reason. In fact, Indonesia made it on my top 10 list of places to live in the world. But when it comes to retiring, there's a couple issues with Bali. I mean, the big thing is that it's just very far away. It's an island in an island chain. So if you are coming from North America or Europe and you're going to be retiring to Bali, it's just really far away, like going to the Philippines. So if you really want to settle on that side of the world, I think it's great. Of course, right now it is a difficult time as we're filming this during the pandemic, but there are a lot of plans for Bali to reopen their borders for travel and tourism. And also they're developing some new remote work and digital nomad visas. So if you have a retirement income, that can make it really affordable for you to live in Bali for up to 5 years if their visa goes through without having to apply for any sort of permanent residency status. So that could be a good option for you. Next up, we have the best places to retire under $1,500 per month, according to another fellow YouTuber, Harry Skerry. So Harry chose Tulum, Mexico as his number one spot, which surprises me to see on a list of the best places under $1,500 per month, because Tulum is actually the most expensive town in that region in the Maya Riviera of Mexico. So if you're considering that area for your retirement, then you're going to want to look at places like Playa del Carmen just to the north, or even Puerto Aventuras, which is between Tulum and Playa del Carmen. You'll get a lower cost of living and a lot fewer digital nomads dancing around on your beach. Another place to look at this area is actually between Cancun and Playa del Carmen. There are a lot of golf course communities. There's a lot of really nice neighborhoods that are kind of out of the downtown core of Playa Centro, and you can get more affordable housing there and still have the same access to amenities, the same great climate, and the same nice quality of life. So I do like the Yucatan area of Mexico as a retirement destination. I'm just not sure I would choose Tulum. But what if you're from the US and you don't want to head south of the border? What is the best US city for you to retire to? Well, US News and World Report does an annual report on this, and so let's see who won in 2021. Sarasota, Florida. Number one best place to retire with a score of 7.6 out of 10. And it looks like they chose Sarasota because of the art scene and also the beautiful beaches and the foodie culture. I really like Sarasota as a U.S. retirement destination. I actually used to live around that area on the Gulf Coast over in St. Pete, Florida, and my sister used to always joke with me whenever we were FaceTiming, and she would ask like, oh, how are you enjoying your retirement? Because in the screen, she could just see all of the beaches and the palm trees and everything around me, and she just said it always looked like I was retired. And you know, maybe I was living my digital nomad retirement life. If you're looking for a beach town in the United States, then it's really hard to beat Sarasota because it has that beautiful water, the sailing, the boating, a really nice arts and cultural scene, lots of live music. You've got lots of breweries over there, and it's just a nice place to enjoy a nice beverage at sunset. There are also no state taxes in Florida, and the cost of living is pretty moderate as well. So, good choice. Now let's see what another one of my favorite YouTubers, Briggs, has to say about that, because I know he does a lot of top 10 lists. Mesquite, Nevada. Did not see that coming. What the heck? I need more information. Okay, so he says that he chose this place because you can get your real estate under $150,000, but there are a ton of places around the world where you can get a condo for less than $150,000. And according to my Facebook poll, the cost of real estate was at the bottom of people's priorities when it comes to where they want to retire abroad. So I think out of all of the places in the world, like, sorry, Briggs, but I'm probably not going to pick a desert. There are probably a lot of similar places in Nevada with a similar cost of living. So for me, that doesn't necessarily stand out as one of the best places in the US to retire, but it could be for you. To each their own. I've never heard of it personally, but if you've ever been to Mesquite, Nevada, let us know in the comments what we're missing. Now in sixth place, what about the best tax-free destination to live? Well, to answer that question, we're gonna have to go over to none other than our friend, the Nomad Capitalist. Let's see what he has to say. So Andrew's recommending the United Arab Emirates, which is a really interesting choice, but I can definitely see why. I just did a lot of research on Dubai specifically for their new remote work visa, and so I was reading about all of the reasons that foreigners go to live there, but I'm not sure that I would recommend it as a retirement destination specifically, and I don't think that's what Andrew's doing here. I think he's just saying the best tax-free country. But for retirement, I mean, first of all, it's really hot. So it's not a place that you would want to live year round. And it is pretty far removed from Europe and from North and South America, from Southeast Asia and Australia. It's kind of isolated. It's a different time zone. It's a different culture. You might be far away from your friends and family from home. And so it has quite a few pros and cons, but if you're looking for a tax-free destination with a high quality of life, English-speaking population, very modern, lots of amenities, UAE could be the place. And wherever you decide to live your best retirement life, you might want to consider learning a new skill on Skillshare, the sponsor of this video. Skillshare offers thousands of inspiring classes for creative and curious people on topics like illustration, design, photography, video, freelancing, and more. It's a place where you can explore new skills, deepen an existing passion, or just get lost in your creativity. I really like this class by Jessica on portrait photography, especially if you're going to be traveling or living abroad and you want to document your experience. In fact, I used Skillshare in 2017 to learn how to use my new camera equipment and to start this YouTube channel. It's never too late to start learning something new. The first 1,000 of my subscribers to click on the link in the description will get a 1-month free trial of Skillshare. Thanks to Skillshare for sponsoring this video. And now let's continue with destination number 5 on our list. In 5th place, let's see what else Andrew has for us because he has a bazillion videos on his channel. I really like the title of this one, Where to Retire with $1 Million and Live Like a King. Sounds good. Let's see. Now I know that Southeast Asia might be the first assumption when you think of the best places to live with a low cost of living, but as Andrew mentions, Eastern Europe is a great place for that. You can definitely live there for $1,000 or $2,000 per month really well. And the real estate is also very affordable there. So Serbia, Albania, Bulgaria, I have a lot of videos, especially about Serbia and Bulgaria on my channel, because they do offer so much. They're modern countries with good infrastructure and amenities, really good food. You've got the four seasons. You can go skiing in the winter. You've got hiking in the summer. You have city life. You have the beaches. There's a lot of variety in Eastern Europe, and it's a really underrated region. I even have a video on the most underrated places to live in Eastern Europe. I think he's including Georgia in this list as well. Okay, we are getting into the end of the list with some heavy hitters now. And in fourth place, we have the Internation's Expat Insider Survey from 2020. So these are ranking the best cities and countries for expats to live in the world. Valencia, Spain. First out of 66 countries on healthcare and climate. And another city in Spain, Alicante, came in second. So we've got their top two best cities in the world for expats, both in Spain, with Lisbon, Portugal coming in third. I really like Spain as a retirement destination in general, regardless of which city you choose. I actually have a video on the cost of living in Spain where we go through Madrid, Barcelona, Valencia, Sevilla, so check that video out too. But Spain is great. You've got a really low cost of living, a really great climate that's very mild year-round, amazing food, of course, and a really high quality of life overall. It's a really friendly place, and you can get by without speaking Spanish, although it's best to learn the local language. But there's a lot to explore in Spain. And then, of course, you're just right over the border from Portugal, France, and close to other countries if you want to travel throughout Europe. So in third place, let's see what Internations chose for their number one destination for expats in 2021. Taiwan, followed closely behind by Mexico and Costa Rica, two extremely popular retirement destinations. So it says here that Taiwan ranked first out of 59 destinations for the third year in a row in their survey, and it also came in first in quality of life. And 96% of foreigners living there rated their healthcare system highly. And they chose Taiwan because not a single expat feels personally unsafe. That's very promising. And although I haven't been to Taiwan yet, I did interview an expat family that was living there. And then you can listen to their story in my podcast. In second place, we have International Living's number one choice for the best place to retire in the world in 2021. Let's see what they say. Costa Rica. Couldn't have a best places to retire list without Costa Rica, am I right? And it seems that the universe does have a sense of humor, because if you know me, it's quite possible that you found my channel through a little video called Why Expats Leave Costa Rica. So I'll let you watch that video to balance out this opinion with International Living ranking it as the number one destination in the world, so that you can get both sides of the story. But it is true that Costa Rica has a lot to offer for retirees. I mean, the weather is good. There are some areas like Atenas, but a lot of places in the Central Valley that have some of the best climates in the world. You've got the beaches, the fresh food, lots of organic markets, the slow pace of life, and it's a beautiful place. I mean, I lived in Costa Rica for 8 years. If you've never been there, it can be a great place to live for a while. They've got this new Costa Rica digital nomad visa coming out that perhaps retirees can qualify for with your social security or retirement income. And then you can stay in Costa Rica for up to 1 or 2 years with just a passport without applying for permanent residency there. And so it says here you can live in Costa Rica on $2,000 a month. That would be tight, but there's certainly rental properties that go for $2,000 a month. So locals can live in Costa Rica for $2,000 a month, but for retirees, you're going to have to live a pretty modest lifestyle to make it there. Costa Rica is one of the more expensive countries in Latin America. So if you're looking to save money, then Mexico is much cheaper. Panama is a good alternative as well. So in 2020, they chose Portugal, which, to be honest, should also be on any best places in the world to retire list, because Portugal is one of those places that just checks all the boxes. You've got the sunny climate, you've got a moderate cost of living, you're right next door to Spain, you've got amazing food. You can choose from the cities or the beaches. There's a lot of different places to live. There's a lot of variety, and it's also really safe. Congratulations, you've made it to the end of our journey. And the number one place that I recommend for you to retire in the world is, drumroll please, wherever the heck you want. That's right. If you have worked your entire life to enjoy retirement, you should be able to live wherever is the best place for you. Yes, of course you should do your research. Of course you should look at the data, look at the cost of living in all these different places. But at the end of the day, even if there's a place that looks perfect on paper, once you get there, if you don't feel comfortable, if you don't feel at home there, and if you don't love it, then you shouldn't have to stay. Choosing a place to retire is really similar to choosing a life partner. Sometimes it doesn't make sense to anyone else except you. You should go to the place that appeals to you the most, that fits your budget, and that you're going to enjoy, and that's going to be different for every one of you. But where do you dream of retiring? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. Remember to vote in our retirement poll and give this video a thumbs up either way. And if you're planning on moving to a foreign country in the next couple years and you'd like some guidance and support, then feel free to reach out at orbisrelocation.com.